We want to solve the given quadratic equation by completing the square. Completing the square is one of many ways to solve a quadratic equation. This video does assume you've already watched the mini lesson that outlines the following five steps for completing the square. If you haven't done so, you may want to watch that video or at least pause the video and review these steps. So the first step here is to move the constant to the right side of the equation. So to do this, we'll have to undo this plus 2 by subtracting 2 on both sides of the equation. This will give us x squared plus 5x. Now we are going to make this a perfect square trinomial by adding a constant here. So we'll put plus blank equals, and on the right side we'll have a negative 2. And then to maintain equality, we'll also have to add the same constant that we add here. So we'll have plus blank here as well. Now the next step is to make the left side a perfect square trinomial. If we look at our notes below here, if we have a quadratic trinomial with a leading coefficient of 1, the constant term would need to be b divided by 2 squared, where b is the coefficient of the middle term, to make this a perfect square trinomial. So in this example, notice that b is positive 5, so b divided by 2 squared would be 5 halves squared, which would be 25 fourths. So we need to add 25 fourths here on the left as well as on the right. Now this will factor into a perfect square trinomial, and then we need to add the terms on the right. The fact that this is a little bit more challenging because the constant is a fraction, but if we take a look at these notes below here, the constant in the binomial factor is b divided by 2, the term we had here before we squared. So in our case, b over 2 was 5 halves, which means this will factor into two binomial factors. X and x are the factors of x squared, and the factors of 25 fourths that add to 5 are 5 halves and 5 halves. So we'll have plus 5 halves here and plus 5 halves here. And then on the right side, negative 2 is equal to negative 8 fourths. Okay, so on the left we can write this as the quantity x plus 5 halves squared equals, on the right, negative 8 fourths plus 25 fourths would be 17 fourths. And now we can solve for x by undoing the square by taking the square root of both sides of the equation. Remember, when we do this, we would have a plus or minus sign here to obtain both solutions to this equation. So on the left we have one factor of x plus 5 halves, and on the right we would have plus or minus. The numerator is going to be the square root of 17. The denominator would be the square root of 4, which is equal to 2. And then our last step is to subtract 5 halves from both sides of the equation. So we have x equals, this would be negative 5 over 2 plus or minus square root 17 over 2. We also need to recognize that square root 17 does not simplify. So in this case, we have two real irrational solutions. And because we have a common denominator, if we wanted to, we could write this as negative 5 plus or minus square root 17 all over 2. Again, we have two solutions because one solution is negative 5 plus square root 17 over 2, and one solution is negative 5 minus square root 17 all over 2. Okay, we'll take a look at another example in the next video.